Hello, I'm Dr. Steve Johnson, an Associate Professor of Wildlife Ecology and State Extension Specialist with the University of Florida IFAS. As an Extension Specialist, I regularly receive emails from people wanting to know what kind of frog they found in their yard. Often the species in question is the cane toad, commonly known in Florida as the Bufo toad. In addition to wanting to know what kind of frog they found, people frequently want to know if the frog is a danger to their pets and what they can do to make their yard safe. Let me read you a few emails as an example. The toad photos below are circulating around neighborhoods in the Vero Beach area. Some believe this is the invasive Bufo, aka cane toad. I've looked at a few sites, but honestly, I'm not sure. Can you identify this toad for us, please? Another one. Attached is a photo of a frog or toad I found in my yard, and it is 4 to 6 inches in size. All the other frogs I have were small tree frogs, but they seem to have just disappeared. I just want to verify what kind this is and if it's harmful or not to my pets. And then finally, I live in South Fort Myers. I really think that I have a toad nursery somewhere in my backyard. It's very unfortunate and frightening for me because I have small, inquisitive chihuahuas. If you have any information on how I can keep them away without harming my dogs, please let me know. So to answer these questions and others that I often get, I'm going to use this video to tell you about Bufo toads. We're going to cover when and how they arrived in Florida, their general biology, where they occur in the state, and the impacts they're having. But perhaps the biggest concern at this point in time is their potential to poison your pet dog or cat. So I'll tell you some of the symptoms a poisoned pet may show, how to respond, and maybe most importantly, what steps you can take to prevent toad poisoning to begin with. So the cane toad is also known as the giant toad, marine toad, or more commonly, the Bufo toad. It's a non-native invasive species in Florida. These are large toads and they can grow to 3 to 6 inches long. And being toads, they have a stocky build with warty skin. They're usually brownish in color and may have lighter blotches on their back and speckled bellies. Cane toads are native to extreme southern Texas and Central America as well as South America. They were introduced in Florida several times during the 1930s to the 1950s, early on as a potential form of biological pest control, which didn't work, by the way. Many of these introductions were not successful, and the cane toads today in Florida are thought to be from the escape or release, intentional or not, of toads in Miami by a pet importer back in the 1950s. Today, cane toads may be found in Central and South Florida. Roughly, they're in Florida in the area south of the I-4 corridor, which runs from Tampa to Daytona. And cane toads in Southwest Florida near Naples and Fort Myers are currently expanding their range to the east and to the north. So if you live in that area, you really need to be on the lookout for this animal. So in Florida, cane toads are mainly found in areas where there are people. Habitats for toads include suburban neighborhoods, schoolyards, golf courses, and even agricultural areas. Currently, unfortunately, cane toads have not invaded many natural areas in the state. Adult cane toads are most active at night, emerging from hiding places usually around dusk to forage for insects, small vertebrates, or even pet food left outdoors. Young cane toads may be active in the daytime, and scientists think they are active in the daytime because doing so avoids them being eaten by larger toads, which are usually active at night. Cane toads are out and about most during the spring and summer when the conditions out are warm and humid, and they may be especially active during and after rainstorms. In South Florida, they could be active during any month of the year. They breed in canals, ditches, and retention ponds and lay their thousands of eggs in long strings. As I mentioned, cane toads are considered an invasive species in Florida. An invasive species is defined as any organism moved to an area outside its native range by people that has negative impacts to the environment, human quality of life, or the economy in the place where it's been introduced. The main negative effects that cane toads are currently having in Florida are to human quality of life, as well as economic impacts to people who have to seek medical treatment for a pet that's been unfortunately poisoned by a cane toad. So cane toads pose a real serious threat to domestic pets, especially to dogs that are prone to attack small animals. The toads have large poison glands on each shoulder, and when a dog bites down on the toad, these glands either squirt or ooze out a creamy colored thick poison. Left untreated, this poison can be lethal to your pet. Symptoms of cane toad poisoning in dogs include pawing at the face and mouth, frothing or foaming at the mouth, dark red gums, disorientation or frantic behavior, whining, seizures, and in extreme cases, even death. If you suspect that your pet's been poisoned by a cane toad, there are several steps that you can take to alleviate the symptoms and maybe save your pet's life. And you have to act fast. First of all, take a wet rag and wipe out the inside of your pet's mouth. Be sure to wipe the tongue, the gums, and the inside and outside of your pet's lips. Toad poison is very thick and sticky, and you want to be thorough with the rag. Next, use a garden hose with a steady but not too strong flow to thoroughly rinse your pet's mouth out for about 10 minutes. And be sure to point the mouth of your pet in a downward direction so the water runs out of the mouth and not down the throat. Afterwards, call your local veterinarian for additional advice, and they're probably going to ask you to bring your pet in for exam. And be sure to have the number of your local emergency animal hospital on hand well ahead of time. And as the old adage goes, an ounce of prevention is worth a pound of cure. So I strongly encourage you to take steps that will help your pet avoid a negative interaction with the cane toad in the first place. So if you live in an area where Bufo toads are known to occur, consider doing the following to avoid conflicts with these toxic toads. First of all, keep a close eye on your pet when it's outdoors. Walk your dog on a short leash, especially at night when you can keep the dog close to you. Don't allow your pet to sniff around and under bushes where toads may hide, especially during the evening. And make your yard less attractive to toads by doing the following. Trim shrubs short so the limbs don't touch the ground and provide spaces for toads to hide. Remove any debris and clutter that can attract cane toads to your yard. Turn off any outside lights at night that attract insects, which in turn attract the toads. Now, if you're not comfortable shutting off your lights at night, replace your current bulbs with yellow so-called bug lights that won't attract insects, or consider installing motion sensor security lights, which are not constantly on and won't invite insects. Also, do not leave pet food out at night. Toads will learn you have an easy meal in your yard. Additionally, you want to empty out pet water bowls at night and eliminate other sources of water and moisture in your yard. Cane toads will seek out these water sources, especially during dry conditions. And finally, seriously consider removing cane toads from your property, especially if you have dogs. They can be easily captured by hand and humanely euthanized. But before euthanizing a possible cane toad, be sure you've properly identified it to avoid accidentally killing a native toad. To learn more about toad identification and proper methods for humane euthanasia, watch the second and third short videos in this series. Thank you for watching this video and your interest in cane toads. Learn more about them by reading the fact sheet at the web address on your screen. And for more information on invasive animals and plants, please contact your local U.S. IFAS County Extension Office.